Good news, because finally it looks like it's about to happen. What seemed like a proverbial white elephant on the side of the highway in Taruba is actually a work site that is nearing completion. The Brian Lara Stadium and Cricket Academy has a date set for its official launch. Nasir Mohammed went on a tour of the new facility.
And it looks like it's going to be finally finished. The Brian Lara Stadium with a Brian Lara Cricket Academy is about to be launched in a proposed date of May 2017 by the Minister of Sport and Youth Affairs, Darrell Smith.
We'll be doing a major launch. We're working with him. At the end of the day, it's to honor him. He's a world icon. He's a treasure that we have here in Trinidad. And in May, we'll be having a fantastic launch that the whole world will be stopping to watch Trinidad and Tobago.
The Keith Rowley-led government allocated $90 million last year for the completion of the stadium, and Minister Smith announced that costs were currently at $86 million. He lamented that 10 years was wasted because of unnecessary political games, when the youths of TNT and the Caribbean could have been flourishing at the world-class venue.
It's about the human resource, it's about the young people, it's about our greatest resource that we have, which are the athletes and the young people of Trinidad and Tobago. And if you work out 10 years as primary school and secondary school, we have lost a generation of young people. You know, when we were out there, we were hearing the nostalgia of the recording of Brian Lara when he broke the record. How many more memories, how many more records we could have broken here with that lost generation of 10 years? How many young people could have passed there, male and female, could have come here and broken records for the West Indies, for other countries, for Trinidad and Tobago?
UDCOT, who is in charge of the construction, will hand over the facility to the care of the Sport Company of Trinidad and Tobago, who will handle the maintenance and day-to-day operations of the facility. TTCB executive member and former Minister of Sport Manohar Ramsaran is confident of receiving swift certification from the International Cricket Council.
As you see here today, we are not far from that with our own limited experience. This is not too far at all from being certified, if I may say so.
In its original format, it was meant to be an academy-like facility for training and development, both on and off-field, with classrooms and video facilities to help athletes and coaches. The TTCB is keen to get access to the facility for regional and international matches, while the Caribbean Premier League is also interested in staging matches at the venue later this year. Reporting for C Sports from Taruba, I am Nasira Mohammed.
Yes, you can call me at 622-AGENT, A-G-E-N-T.